Der Bayer, namely in English, the Bavarian, is a species with less brain capacity. Der Bayer, the Bavarian, is a term all over Germany to depict the idiot. Der Bayer listens to Oompa Oompa music, Oompa Oompa Oompa. Der Bayer has no interest in knowledge. Der Bayer don't read the signs and do not understand the symbols. Der Bayer is all over not recognized in Bayern, Bavaria, as such as all Bavarians are Bayern and all Bavaria is filled with Bavarians, so there is no special Bavarian among the Bavarians. Der Bayer, the Bavarian, dresses suits and tucked in shirts and also very fat bellies because the symbol of a status of Der Bayer, the Bavarian, is food. Weichwurst, it's a form of gross sausage, is Der Bayer's favorite food. And Der Bayer, the Bavarian, is extremely racist. Otherwise, how could Der Bayer survive in middle of the Europe's, in middle of Mozart's birthplace, and Liszt's, and all nice German educative things? How could Der Bayer survive? If not, it would be by farting on the foreigners, Ausländer. Der Bayer is the ultimate arsehole.
Who's that sexy thing I see over there? That's me, standing in the mirror. What's that icy thing hanging round my neck? That's gold, show me some respect.
A boom bale, bum bum ba boom bale, boom ba ching boom bale. Which language are we talking? Does it matter? It is the language. We do understand. Seek not, my little saltamontes. Just listen. Listen. Tart. Tart.
Tart.
Tart. Tart. Unstoppable.
Unstoppable.
Tart.
When I was 10, I lost my 11 brothers and sisters. You know, the boys and girls who beat me. So my mother bought me an oven like this one over there. And it's called Emaille in German. It's an oven, it fit on my desk. Yeah, I couldn't hug him with my two hands, very heavy. And it heats up to like 1100 degrees Celsius. Remember, 100 degrees Celsius is the boiling point. So it's extremely hot. So she gave me one of those when I was 10, so I wouldn't feel so alone. And she would buy me other things. But basically, this works like that. You make jewelry out of it. You buy metal, and then you buy material. Like, it looks like little plastic, anything, shapes of heart, crumbles or something. And you put that over the metal, which you prepare. Then you put that in the oven. And what you get is a jewelry like that. I think this is a professional thing for like professional herreros. Well, I handled that very nicely over myself. Yes. And right now it's a little bit of a laughing thing, right? But yeah, well, I did all this. The art was, or the craft was to put the colors in a way. It would, when it melts, create beautiful shapes. And yes, this is what I did when I was 10, when I was 11, when I was 12, when I was 13. I don't know if I continued when I was 14. I don't remember. I think then I grew out of it. Oh yeah, then another thing came to my life. Silberdraht. That was in some kind of summer camp. I learned that to make jewelry out of silver wire, with pinzas. With tools. With tools. And I did that for a very long time. I made my own earrings. Maybe, yeah, you may say hippie style, but my work was high quality. I know that, like, I noticed what could go wrong and what wasn't. So I created my own earrings. I did that for a very long time. And I wore those, pretty much only those, for a very, very long time. And yeah, when I was in Mexico for a while, when I was totally jobless, was it before or after the hotel? For a few months I lived with that. I think 2 months I lived out of that by selling my craft at the office. Some offices. Yeah, it is probably amazing that I handled such dangerous material. I like doing it. It was okay. One more thing to learn. All right, back to my pueblo. Mis queridos bolangueros y mis flaponos chingoneros, it might come to you as a surprise. Yet, if you say la raza, you're on your own. I'm not in there. But if you want to get intimate in my Spanish language, I'd say, oh, quite not there yet. Let me see. Not there yet. Yeah, no. Still feeling into it. Yeah, there is a word I haven't used yet. Together. I haven't used it yet. Yet, not yet. But I may or may not. I am so sorry to my non-Spanish speaking friends and family. Yeah, man, it's really not that worth the while. And for strange that it may sound, a movie like Cinema Paradiso, which was a huge wave in Mexico City, and maybe in other cities too, or maybe not, in La Muestra. It is a movie which only and solely was appreciated in my Mexico. Yes, Mexico lindo y querido. The sensitivity and the emotion depicted in that little Italian movie about a little boy who learned the craft of showing movies. And they didn't call him Cácaro, but people used to call them in La Cineteca such. Yeah, it also escaped la majority de mi pueblo in Mexico, these finesses we had in Mexico. Cinema. Great stuff. Good stuff. Yeah, quite not there yet with this word. Yeah, tienes ventaja. Yeah, you would not have thought so. You're privileged in a way. Yeah. Sí. Te das cuenta? I mean, did you realize that the great music was only made by, you know, su chingadera servidora and su servidor? Yeah, pinche chingona la güerita. Now I said it. Otherwise, what are you gonna go be jealous about the whites? Huh? The red skin? Oh, I include myself again, the red skin too. I mean, honestly, yeah, the only thing superlative in Mexico is la vulgaridad. Yeah, try la trash, man. It's up to you not to. Oh, güerito. Oh, you had to say it, huh? Oh, we were starting to feel good and now again. Yeah, again, man. Think about it. Pinche silke. Pinche güera. Yeah, pinche.